personalize the way you see everything, and then conquer. Exclusive Black Equalizer brightens dark scenes without overexposing bright areas. Use the S-switch to quickly access the setting and switch between save modes. Adjust the angle effortlessly for maximum comfort.
Welcome back to the BenQ ZOWIE All-Star Showmatch between mousesports and Fab Gaming, aka Fab Game Esports. We will head into the second map, which is Train, the map pick of mousesports, not the map pick of Fab Gaming. I already apologize to everyone before. I had a pipe breach at my flat. So I'm still mentally in my flat worrying about stuff because we try to fix it. But the real technician is coming tomorrow morning. So I hope that I come home and the house is still there. That I would appreciate that. I would also appreciate you guys sticking around and having some fun with me. Mousesports already showed some really nice strategies on Mirage. Since NKJ is playing instead of Chris J, they figured our main AWP player is not around. So what should we do now? It's probably the best idea to get 5 AWPs, because if we have 5 AWPs, the chances are really good that one of us gets an AWP frag. So that's how they tried to replace Chris J. If you have 5 guys with AWPs, they must be just as good as Chris J. And it's not live, by the way. Nico. Look at that. They're having some fun together as well. Very nice. Nico is mad. Cause bad. No, yeah. I hope he's coming back now. Our dear admin, big shout out to him, Major Rabbit. Doing his very best to keep the madness at bay. So some trolling going on here. Ah, I know, the problem is Nico joins the wrong team or something? Yeah, now he's on the right team. Everything's okay now. Everything's okay in the end. I hope that my flat is okay as well, because otherwise I need a swing, a life vest to get in there. That was really awkward, you know. Just for everyone tuning in, I wanted to get a shower before I went to the studio, and there was something wrong, let's say it like that, and I realized there must be something horribly wrong. And then I figured, oh, it's a pipe break. My neighbor was shouting and stuff like that. It was like a huge emergency. We thought the world would go under. It didn't happen. Luckily, it didn't go under. But our flats were a little watery. So I had to run 10 minutes to the studio to get here in time. And of course, I didn't shower anymore. So I'm glad you can't... Why do I say stuff like that on stream? I really don't know, but I think you can imagine. I'm salty, let's say it like that. FaZe will get the knife round over with in the end. And Speedy with a quad kill in there. What a performance by him. Yeah, Fab with a CT start on Train. I hope the very best for them. I would love to see Cash between the two teams. Cash is a... Historically speaking, if we want to quote one of the most historically most respected historians of CS, historically speaking, a German map. We will find out if Fab Gaming can pull it back on Train. So So they will kick it off on the CT side. Mousesports with 5 Glocks, 4 armors. And NKJ being their support player. He's standing in for Chris J, by the way, for everyone just tuning in. I hope that you realize that NKJ was or is, I mean, he is one of their coaches. They have Capio as well, an X1.6 legend who also played for Mousesports together with Gob B, by the way. So that's a cool storyline as well. And NKJ is their coach, so he knows all the executions they want to play. And he, generally speaking, he knows how to play the game himself as well, so there shouldn't be that big of a problem. Maybe he's not too warmed up at the moment, but he's showing that he's worthy of playing this game with Hatchet onto 3 men, making it a 5v2 already. And Batcher is the only one around here on the A-bomb side. He's in a firefight with Nico, and that's something, you know, there is that saying, you brought a knife to a gunfight, but you brought a pistol to a Nico fight, and that goes with any weapon. You brought two guys to a Nico fight, doesn't matter, he will take you all down. So Fab Gaming with the Seuss buy. Going for something cheeky here. Oh, but that spot was taken already. Strunk trying to get around and get something else going. Didn't really happen for him. 3 men might get that. Oh, that was so close on Dennis. Now Batcher, the last hopes of the Seuss family. They won't really, I mean, they, yeah, next could put, no, not anymore. Oh, they didn't hear him. It's getting close, it's getting dangerous. I really should have prepared some graphics and some music like Raheem does. Oh, long range Seuss, that's not gonna work out. And NKJ finally gets him. Mousesports with a 2-2-0. Not losing a single man in this round. A lot of money for the terrorists. The CT's already facing the rough reality of not getting the first round on the board. So Mousesports will have a 3-2-0 lead. I don't really think that there is a possibility for Fab Gaming to win this full eco. And at the same time, if anything should go wrong, I don't know what that lag was about. If anything should go wrong, Mousesports still have Nico, right? The savior of souls. Ah, oh, how did 3 men not hit that Seuss? I thought that we had a pause or something, but probably isn't. Doesn't matter. That lag was a one-off thing. But this round win for Mousesports is probably not. The best of 3 score is 1-0 in favor of Mousesports. I'm currently working on getting that score displayed on your screens at home. That's also why I'm still a little distracted, but we should focus on this rifle round as Fab Game go for the double orb setup. It's David on the bomb train. He shuts down the first one. Dennis with a quick reply takes it back to a 4v4, but Nex is down to 7 HP already. Should be an easy frag for the CTs if they spot him. That's a real thing right now. They need to find him as well. David goes for another peek and goes down to Speedy. Good covering fire. Batcher with the reply onto Nex. 2v2 now, thanks to Batcher doing some work from Ivy. Phaser has the backline under control. Terra's with Nico and Speedy working together. Speedy with a bomb on his back. He plants it in safety. Nico is in the probably safest spot at the moment. Speedy looking for the CTs. Nobody's showing at his screen. Fab Gaming want to wait for the terrorists to make a mistake. And Nico is going to pressure the CTs. He's going for the encounter. Speedy will shut down Badger. And now Nico knows where the last one should be. Already tracking him down. And Speedy picks up his 4th frag off the round with the orb. I doubted. I was wondering why Speedy picked up the orb, but he's shown his worth as well. 4-0 in favor of Mousesports, but but went down the wire. And I don't think that they were fooling around in this round. They were playing it maybe not as focused as they would play on a major, that's for sure. But they were not fooling around in some, you know, weird decisions or anything like that. Also, good start for the round for the CTs with David K getting the AK out of Pop Dog. Interis will go for the B bomb set and a good nade. Three man cashes out or crashes out and dashes out, and I don't know, he just does damage. The terrorists will have to fight through the CT lines here next with a good angle onto David K. Bomb will be planted by AKJ. He's getting flanked by Freeman. He's such a tremendous player here for Fab Gaming. And FaZe was about to get knifed by Nico. Gets another frag. Pulls it back into 1v1. The bomb just went down. Next with a triple kill. He has to make it a quad in his team, in his favor, if he wants to win the round for his team. And he has the right timing. That was simply unlucky for FaZe. What a great display by Fab Gaming here, even though it's already 5-0, and that's not a good scoreline for the CTs at the moment. At least they have some amount of hope in those rounds. Okay, Dennis, he's going off like a rocket. David K does the same, but Nico comes around through the smoke. And Nico is just standing there like a turret, you know? He walks through the smoke. Then he sees one over here and one over here. He doesn't make a move anymore. He just stays stationary. Pew pew, first kill, pew pew, second kill. No problem for me. It's just amazing to watch this guy. And I've been watching him from the, wow, from the very old days when he was still playing with YNK, for example, and Intel, in the Serbian Bosnian squad, kind of. That was really long ago, but Nico is now the last man standing. Another chance for him to show what he's made of against Badger and Threeman, and they're probably shaking already, sweating blood and tears. Some water in there as well. Oh, good timing though on the CTs. And you know, that's exactly how you can counter a very good individual player. If you have some team play, if you have the right timing, you don't even give him a chance. If he doesn't see you, he can't kill you. It's as easy as that. Of course, you're not always in a position to do those things, and you're not always having the communication as well. Sometimes it's chaotic and stuff like that. But if you have the right composure, you can keep him out of control and at bay. Ah, FaZe goes down to NKJ. That shouldn't have happened. 3 minutes down to 18 HP as well. And the terrorists don't have any reason to push at the moment. They can still slow it down. They can wait for another frag to open up the rounds with. That's Speedy and Dennis shutting down the CTs. Strong with a double kill, though. The CTs still put up some resistance. Very resilient showing by Fab Gaming, I gotta give them that. Not all the teams would have the mental strength to keep it together at this stage of the game. Nico with a good kill to close it out. 7-1 in favor of mousesports. 10 frags for Dennis. 9 for Nex. And Nico only on 8. What is wrong with Nico? Is he maybe injured? I don't know. See Nico on only 8 frags in 8 rounds? There's something wrong with him. Must have changed his mouse sensitivity. I'm just trolling him. The CTs with that, well, upgraded pistol by Batcher with armor as well. And he will get an AK, and it's a 3v3. Still a good fighting chance for the CTs, but Nico's just waiting for him. So accurate. I think I don't really have to come and hit anything anymore. We just stay with Nico now and just stare in awe. Are you with me, chat? Let me know. And yet, oh, I tried to see Nico go off again, but sadly, NKJ and Dennis weren't that good of a teammates. They didn't let him get any frags here. Yes, Nico cam. Okay, Nico cam. Yeah, I'm so glad I don't have to focus on camera anymore. Oh, I want to switch though. Look at Nico. Now he has to go back and get the bomb. Why would you let Nico do that? Ah. No, no. Okay, now it's cool to see Nico. He's got the bomb. He sent in his living decoys as a distraction to the CT, so the CTs can't tell where Nico is coming from. Ah! Oh, yes! It was worth the wait. Thanks, Nico. Ah, oh, come on. Another one shot. Do it. Do it. Do it. 52 seconds on the clock still. Counting down. The CT's got themselves in position to surround him. If he gets one of those frags, especially the one in connector, would be really important for him. And he knows there is somebody there. It's almost always somebody in C connector. Come on. Come on, three men! Grow some balls! Be a man! No, Nico. He has to fake to draw them out like rats. They're coming from the holes, and David K is taking him down. Fed Gaming will get their second round. Let's see what Nico is up about to do here. Nico with a full buy, AK, flash, smoke, and Molotov for him. And he's using a knife to speed up a little bit here. Rushing down into Ivy, using his teammates as distraction again. Next with the first kill though, Batcher will trade it back. Still, some frags left for Nico, four apiece. Now he's got. Oh, what is wrong with Batcha? You can't do that to Nico without any punishment in the next rounds. Nico must be furious about that. Speedy and NKJ up against the three CTs. And the CTs will not let them get out. And Nico will open up the round. They bought an AWP for him. Why not? Now, his teammates will push through and that will not keep the camera on Nico all the time. Oh, well, I have to now. Sadly, he's alone again. Oh, yeah! That's Nico again! Giving me shivers down my spine. The CT's all around him. He needs to watch out. Oh, three bullets left in the clip. He has to reload soon. Reloading the AWP is not really pleasant. But he's gonna be flanked by three men. So Fab Gaming will make it happen. They are mounting the comeback. Three rounds in a row. I'm enjoying myself with the chat here. Drunk going right in there into the thick of things he goes, but Dennis, well, there's both of him in the smoke. Dennis looking for some more frags. Where is Nico? Nico's with his teammates in the smoke with a deagle. He's blazing it. Look at that. David goes down instantly. Speedy has that opening he wanted to have. He's just pushing through there. Speedy goes down though. Next with a tech 9 kill. Nico got himself an M4A1. Three men will dispose of next. And Phaser behind the bomb train. Nico is there, but he goes down to Phaser. It's up to Dennis. And he has been quite a force to reckon with at the moment. Especially in this game. He had a rough patch in the past few weeks, or months rather. And he's working his way back in shape. At least he's showing that he has some shape regained here in this game. The chat is awesome. I mean the chat in the game as well. Speedy is lost for words. I will translate later on. Dennis and three men in the 1v1. Can three men clutch this for Fab Gaming to close the distance? If they get six rounds, they still have a fighting chance in this game and in this map as well. And there goes the clutch. Three men will get a 2k only. And he's going back for the orb, I guess. Does he have enough time? Yes, he does. Yeah, I will translate. So we have the time to translate. Skrunk said, nice hug, Nicholas. That is NKJ. NKJ said, yeah, that's straight from the heart. And Skrunk said, yeah, I realized, or yeah, I felt that. And then they said, oh, hug, hug. And NKJ says, yeah, I don't know what the translation is, really weird, but it's kind of a kiss with a little of biting, you know? Just a little chewing on the neck. And then NKJ said, well, Speedy knows exactly who's that aimed at. And Skrunk said, I would continue, but there are too many viewers. And too many young viewers. Yeah. Yeah, that was really kinky. That was really kinky with the neck biting. That's why Speedy said dot dot. That was just cringe, you know. Now let's see if mousesports can finally get themselves back on the board. Phaser is doing so much work right now. Let's keep it at Phaser for now. He's got the Phaser cam. Wow, almost twisted my tongue. If I could break my tongue, I probably would have in that moment. Dennis is breaking a leg while trying to get away. And oh, that incinerate. Ah, it's extinguished. Skrunk with a diffuse of love. 6-9. Fab Gaming will get closer to mousesports after a 9-1 scoreline. Fab is pulling it back. Is mousesports choking? I don't know. We will find out later on. In exactly 10 seconds. You see? I called it. I knew exactly when things happen. So it's kind of a cool practice game for both of them. There are 1,000 euros on the line, brought to you by BenQ and Zoe. By the way, if you're confused, wasn't BenQ the screen company, the monitor company? And wasn't Zoe that company with the cool mice? Yes, but they merged. BenQ decided to rebrand their gaming gear to Zoe. And now we have Zoe mice and Zoe screens as well. That's just some background information for everyone that just tunes in. And the CTs with the four-man stack on the A-bomb site. They don't know that the terrorists are so close already. Nico, of course, will get one frag. Then he gets flanked by David K, who picks up two kills in a row before going down. And as they switch through the terrorists, it's Speedy and Nex killing each and every one of them. 10-6 in favor of mousesports. They get both pistol rounds on the board, and now that they start off with a pistol in the back on the CT side, another bomb plan for the terrorists. It should be a downhill match for them. Oh, Dan is with the MP7. Oh no, that's not how you climb ladders. But he finally gets down there. An AUG or next. A Swiss weapon. It's actually a really cool gun. And the bullpup design allows the barrel to be longer. If you compare this one, that's where the bullet comes from here. So the barrel is this long. Whereas on the M4, it's only this long. You see the difference? That makes the AUG a little more accurate and it's got the same amount of stopping power basically, so you can go for long range shots and stuff like that. And you've got that mount. Usually the AUG comes with a fixed scope, but they decided to put a red dot on it in CSGO. I'm a huge fan of the AUG, by the way, not in the game but in real life. No metaphor this time around. The terrorists will throw this round away, trying to do as much damage as possible, and they will get 3 frags. But yeah. So let's find out what Fab is about to do in this first rifle round on the second half. Nico and Nex have the double AWP, the 2N, the double N. But it's a D to get the kill. 3 men with a reply. He also shuts down Speedy, and suddenly it's only 3 CTs on the rotation. They don't know where the main push is coming from, but they over-rotate at the moment. Nico and Nex went for the rotation. And that's 2 AWPs at the same bombsite, leaving NKJ on his own. And he can't get the kill onto Skrunk. The terrorist will reach the A bombsite. It's next to plug that hole. He's on the rotation already, but David K will get rid of him. Nico is alone. He can try this 4v1. Already spotted a glimpse of the terrorist there. Oh, gets flashed. And oh, that no-scope onto Skrunk. That's just horrible to watch. So hard. I mean, Skrunk must be feeling so bad because he thought Nico had some aim in that situation or something, but that was mainly luck. Skrunk and company go for their own double AWP setup on the T side of train. And Phaser is... Well, I was about to say that doesn't make them too versatile, but Phaser is proving me wrong. Glad to see that Fabe is coming back a little bit. Skrunk with a double kill. Nico and NKJ left alone. NKJ goes down, so it's only Nico. Finally, we get back to the Nico cam. He's got a deagle, so can easily battle it out with anyone on the server. But maybe I put some too much pressure on his shoulders. Just reading the chat. Really? How is that even possible? Oh. Wait. Does it work now? All right. Okay. Oh, thanks. As I mentioned before, I rushed to the studio, and yesterday was really late. It was 4 a.m. when I got home. When I left the studio. So there must have been something wrong with XSplit, and I had a pipe breach in my flat, so I didn't have the time to prepare, because I ran here 10 minutes off sprinting to get here in time, because I obviously had to take care of that. You can't let water run into your flat like that. The technician comes tomorrow, so I'm still worried if that, you know, if the pipe gets, I don't know, if it breaches on another point or something like that. I really don't know, so I'm still mentally at home worrying about my flat. And I thank you for pointing that arrow out, by the way, because, and in a serious fashion as well, because otherwise I wouldn't have been able to fix it. So let's focus on the game again, as the terrorists made that 3-round streak work. The CTs are back on the buy. We don't have a Deagle on Nico. That's a huge loss for mousesports. I would have loved to see him Deagle it out with the two orbs. Skrunk on Phaser with a double orb, and I called it not that versatile, and Windows 32 already pointed out that I was completely wrong in that round. I will stay true to my statement, though. It's a little less versatile. But Skrunk and Phaser, they are good orbs, and they can make those things go their way either way. Skrunk has that CT shut off, and Phaser's moving in. Nico just lurking in the smoke at the moment in A main. And it's a huge problem for the terrorists. They can't really rotate that quickly. They have to sneak past Nico. He has a lot of information, and they can't attack the A bombsite anymore either. So they have to get rid of Nico at one way or the other. That's the first Molotov going there. Fab. Well, they should double peek him. Now an aid comes in, a flash comes in, and that's exactly how you handle that situation. Well done by Fabe. In the meantime, Nex got the kill onto Skrung, so it's a 4v3 either way. Nex still on the E-box, and he's showing some little Nico in him. Oh, that was beautiful to see. Nex back with a triple kill. And if you have watched mousesports a year ago or something like that, yeah, I think he was playing for them a year ago already. Pretty sure, yeah. Nex is such a strong player. He's so amazing. He's probably one of the most talented German players. Since the switch with Gob B and all that, he somehow didn't really find a way to get back to his old shape. And I'd love to see him perform as consistently and as well as he did before. That's my wish for mousesports. And if Nex is there, they would be an even bigger threat to anyone. Phaser is a big threat to the CTs as well with his double kill. He's making it a 1v1, and Dennis is lurking around in the back. Ah, Phaser, hide away! He did just in time. Now he knows where Dennis is, and he can plant in safety for now. But it's gonna be enemy at the gates, the sniper duel, and Phaser is so quick. Really good performance by him on train as well as on Mirage. He didn't really fail, even though his name kind of implies. 18 on Phaser. Nico is, yes, but Nex is German. So, the CT is on the save, and they're not stacking anything except for Ivy at the moment. It's Dennis and Nico. Dennis with the armor and Nico behind him. So as soon as Dennis pulls the trigger, Nico knows exactly what's going to happen and he will run away. No. They want to make it together, but it's going to be really hard now for Nico. He knows that they are coming for him, and Skrunk is not letting him get a single frag, not even a single point of damage. Skrunk so quick with the orb. CT's down, three men alive for them. One of them is NKJ. The coach, he's going big with the USP. Just casually clicking away, trying to run for the deagle, run for the heels. But David K is on his heels. Haha, heels and heels, you know. Sorry. And yeah. That didn't end well for NKJ. Mousesports trying to do some damage to the terrorists. Speedy giving away the position. And they're getting ready for the Sue's execution. Speedy will draw the fire, and next is going to be the one to get the frag. He's raving in, but messes up that jump. Gets caught in the doorway. And Speedy at least picks off Badger, so it's one more kill for the CTs. Fab Gaming will get the round, though, and they make Mousesports struggle. Sit down, Speedy. He's taking a nap in the corner. Two rounds separating the two teams. Mousesports needs to refocus. They need to realize, okay, well, guys, we are playing for 1,000 euros. That's quite a lot of money for anyone to, you know, in theory, it should be a quick affair. Winning 1,000 euros, I mean, if you split it by 5, I don't know what that is. 1,000, 5, 200. For either. Wow, sorry. It's 200 euros for every single player in the squad. That's easy money in 2 hours, right? It's 100 bucks per hour. So you don't really want to prolong this if it's not necessary. Mousesports need to realize that, okay, guys, we're about to give Fab Gaming the chance. Not even to prolong the series, but maybe even win it. Speedy and Dennis left alone. No real hope for them anymore. Fab will close the distance to one round only. They were struggling more than Mousesports did on their T side. Shower, yeah, that's my plan. I'm never leaving this job anymore, man. My math is way too bad. I'm an IT admin, by the way. That's my normal job. So I can calculate in binary, no problem. But if they're a decimal, it's not for me, really. So Skrunk and Phaser still have the double orb, and Speedy realizes, okay, it's time to do something special. It's time to boost my teammate. No, not really boosting it. Finally boosting him. But in the meantime, the terrorists already got into the bomb site, and that was just that tiny amount of time they wasted over there. Phaser with the orb shot onto Speedy. That's a terrorist just unleashing their ferocious push. No respect anymore for the CTs. Not even Nico can pull it back. 13-13. Fab Gaming are alive on train. They have chosen this map for a reason. And Mousesports is back on another save. Skrunk. That wasn't even his frag, man. That wasn't his frag. So harsh for him. The CTs are trying to pull it back together. Somehow, Nico pulled off that one frag with the Deagle. We all know how that should have happened. And three men in Badger will shut down the CTs. Nico on his own. And that's sometimes when he's the best. Double kill for him already. Let's go to the Nico cam. Badger on 21 HP. Oh, look at where the bullets go. This is just... Wow. as if the deagle was bent. Now, oh, what? Freeman got sprayed by his teammate David K from behind. But doesn't matter, Fab with a 14-13. Oh, mousesports in a really bad shape right now. Only two rounds for Fab Gaming and they will prolong the series. You have to keep in mind, there's a lot of money on the line. And of course, it's mousesports'... I don't know, when they played their last game against the German team, it must have been ages ago. Possibly years. Centuries. Next and Company will hold it together though. The double N with Nico and Next. Now it's Speedy showing up as well on the B-bomb side. And there goes the second one for Speedy. Fails his backstabbed. He fights his way out of there. But only for a brief second. He catches his breath. And Speedy catches him sitting down. Holding his arms across his chest. Please don't kill me. Speedy has no remorse. 14-14. Mousesports will get back on the board after a 5-round streak on the T side by Fab Gaming. 22 kills for Fails at 20 for 3 men. On the other side we have Nex with 25, 24 for Dennis. And NKJ on 10. You must like this number. So either squad with a back against the wall. The CTs would be able to force it up if they lose this round, but it would be a very weak buy, and Phaser is making it as possible as he can. Just gets away through Nico's crosshair. But now Nico can prepare. Phaser needs to cross a second time. And that's not a shot Nico misses. He's so quick with every single gun. The CTs pull it back to a 4v4. Let's see who is going to come out on top of this one. It's such an amazingly intense and important round here. Speedy's alone on the B-bomb side. They're going to push him with three players. David is still back behind, covering his teammates' backs. And Dennis is playing with the thought of going for the pop dog play. He catches three men off guard. Dennis gets back into the bomb site, but gets ambushed by David K. NKJ having some trouble here against David, but gets the kill. Another trade by the terrorist, though. It's a 2v2 again, and they push Skrunk into the back already. The CTs have to rotate, but they don't know that Skrunk is around. NKJ with a clutch. A 1v2 for NKJ. Skrunk tries to pick him out of the air, but it's Batchov with the kill. Fab Gaming make it 15-14, and now they can make it a third map. It might be cash that we need to find the winner of the $1,000 on. That would be quite an upset. And I said that maybe Fab Gaming could take a map away from mousesports. I don't know if you were around. No, I think I was still muted when I said it. Ha! Well, nobody can prove that I said it. So let's not talk about that. But yeah, I mean... Oh, Next, cuddling his terrorist opponent, Freeman, exchanging the kiss of death. As Dennis with the Deagle hatchet onto Batch and David K with another trade, making it a 4v3, the 4x4, the CTs. It needs to work. It has to work. There is no other way for them. NKJ with a good spray, but Freeman and Phaser win it for Fab Game Esports, 16-14. Phaser kept them in the game with a tremendous effort on the orb. And Threeman got himself 23 kills. Skrunk with 23 as well. Good performance by everyone across the board on Fab Game Esports. Mousesports, we had Dennis doing a lot of work, but Speedy fell off a little bit. I don't think it was necessarily a problem in Mousesports themselves, but the terrorist side of Fab Game Esports, it was so explosive. It was so hard to keep at bay for mousesports. Well done by them. And I hope you enjoyed the second map. We will go for a third one to find the winner of the 1,000 euros. Brought to you by BenQ, aka Zowie, aka BenQ Zowie. And myself, Debu, and 99 Damage. So thank you for tuning in. Stick around for the third map. It's going to be an entertaining game, I guess. Cash between two German teams. Mousesports being the well, I don't want to exaggerate, but it's maybe the world's best cash team, or one of the world's best team on cash. And Fab Game Esports, they are not bad on cash either. So we will see a closer map, at least I hope so, and you will stay around. I know.
Personalize the way you see everything, and then conquer. Exclusive Black Equalizer brightens dark scenes without overexposing bright areas. Use the S-switch to quickly access the setting and switch between save modes. Adjust the angle effortlessly for maximum comfort.